Ooh, it's not looking good for DaisyRidley, who's a little upset that she's not quite getting as many phone calls anymore. And it's almost like she's blaming Star Wars for that, which is pretty funny. So we have another celebrity whining about money, which is kind of funny. Because that's what it is at the end of the day. Now, for the record, I really don't have anything against DaisyRidley. I don't think she's a bad person. In fact, I think she seems like an okay person. And her, another thing with her is she's a much better actress than you get to see in the Star Wars movies. The problem is they have her play this wooden, emotionless, almost character in the movie. She never really shows off any kind of acting chops. This happens quite a bit in movies. Sometimes they're just the actor or the actress just doesn't seem to do it or get it. I don't know. But she's not doing very well. The phone stopped ringing for DaisyRidley after The Rise of Skywalker hit theaters, which was good for her at first. So, as you know, Rise of Skywalker, complete disaster, still made money. I don't want to take that away, because I know there's always the detractors that say, well, it just still made this much money, sir. Well, it's like, well, if you compare it to the other ones, it was still on a downward slope, and that movie was a mess, man. It was funny. That movie, the problem with Rise of Skywalker is it tried to please everybody, and it ended up pleasing nobody. All right. They tried to keep the Last Jedi fans happy and the people that hated Last Jedi. And they ended up really getting the Last Jedi people angry as hell. And then, you know, the people that checked out from the Last Jedi, they were still mad anyway. And there was just really no appeasing anybody. And it was a disaster, and it showed it was a disaster. Anybody that watches that movie and thinks that that was some well-thought-out masterpiece is lying to themselves. That movie was a mess. But we've talked about that. We've talked about that in several videos. Let's talk about Daisy. So DaisyRidley was under the impression that nobody wanted to hire her after The Rise of Skywalker hit theaters late last year. While the Star Wars sequel movies were divisive, Ridley's performances were always praised by critics, and for the most part, by the fans, too. The Twitter fans. Yeah, and been praised by critics. Disney shills that will lick that mouse's boots. Every time he takes a step, it's almost like he takes a step, they lick his boot clean, takes another step. It's like he's constantly getting his boots cleaned while he walks from point A to B. That's how they roll. Critics love kissing the boots of Mickey Mouse. But anyway, after the final movie in the trilogy hit theaters, the phone stopped ringing for the actress, which was a good thing at first, she explains. It was so sad to finish Star Wars when the films were released. I was like, oh my god. It was such a huge chapter, and weirdly, the past few months of not having much, obviously, now is really nice to be working, but not having much. At the time, I feel like I processed the last 5 years to be forced to slow down. It was good mentally for me because Star Wars was a big thing in my life. So taking some time off after starring in 3 Star Wars movies sounds like a wise decision for anybody who starred in the trilogy. So that was a positive thing for Ridley. However, after she had time to slow down and process the last 5 years, she was ready to get to work again. But again, the phone still wasn't ringing. Ridley had this to say. Weirdly, at the beginning of the year, nothing was coming through. I was like, aw, no one wants to employ me. There were actually loads of things that I auditioned for at the beginning of the year, and I didn't get any of them. I had that moment of, oh my God, and then just thought everything in its right time. So she got no work from Star Wars. Now you would think that Star Wars would catapult you to something special. You know, oddly, it seems like, you know, people that star in the Star Wars movies, there's like one actor that will really prosper from it, and the rest of the people kind of just wither away. And it's funny, she talks about voice roles. Like, she's like, oh, I'm still getting work now. I'm getting work. And it's all voice work. Like the interactive Oculus Quest platform titled Baby Yaga. She'll be voicing a character in that. Ooh. Really nailing it down. But like, what is that? Look at the three trilogies, right? So the original trilogy, obviously. The guy who really blew up out of that, Harrison Ford, which you can probably benefit. He had the benefit of Indiana Jones, too, I think, which really helped him. And then for the prequels, Ewan McGregor, obviously, the main guy that takes off out of that. Though he was already kind of big before that, I think. But I can only think of like one person per trilogy. And then obviously the new trilogy would be John Boyega. He's going to get all kinds of work like crazy. And then I think that Oscar guy will probably do okay. But obviously John is the one that's really going to blow up from the new movies. So in the original trilogy, you had Harrison Ford. In the prequels, Ewan McGregor, and now John Boyega. And those are the, I think, the ones that are going to, like, Boyega's going to obviously get a lot of work. But Daisy Ridley, I don't think, she really didn't blow anybody away with that performance. And it's like, you're looking at, okay, well, let's see what Ridley can do. And you go look at some of the stuff she's done, and it's that plastic performance from Star Wars. It's not a good look for her. It was a terrible performance. A terrible performance. And they're not very good movies. They made a lot of money, but I'm telling you, unlike the original Star Wars movies, this new trilogy is not going to stand the test of time. They're generic, manufactured, soulless piles of trash. And I don't see anybody looking back at them fondly in 10 years. Maybe the Mandalorian, but the new Disney trilogy, no one gives a damn about it. And it's looking like nobody gives a damn about Daisy Ridley either. So, interesting stuff. I just want to share this with you guys. It seems like she's kind of blaming Star Wars for her misfortunes. And I think that it's likely true. At the end of the day, I don't think those movies are going to help her career very much. Anyway, that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Please share. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think about all this. Do you think that Star Wars was great, the new trilogy? Do you think that she's great and she's going to be fine? Or do you just find all this funny? Let me know in the comments. Also, make sure you're still subscribed. Subscribe if you're new. Hit that notification bell, and I will see you guys on the next one. Peace. Also, if you want to help support the channel, check out my Teespring store. There's a link in the description. You can find some merchandise in there that you might want to check out.